Now, with our second finalist, we move from senses to defenses. He is a very passionate science communicator, and he claims to be very passionate about science communication and teaching. He is from Russia, where he started to study medicine, then switched the fields, and he also switched the countries. He started studying biology in Germany. But luckily for us tonight, then he moved to Switzerland, precisely to the University of Lausanne, where he is doing his PhD. And he is here tonight to tell us about how pathogens work together to trick our immune system. Please welcome Dmitry Kopeniansky.
Actually, I'm not feeling very well today. Probably I've got some kind of infection. You know, when you have an infection, you're not alone. You've got your immune system to protect you. Let me briefly describe you how it works. Imagine it's a sunny day, you're walking in the street, and then suddenly, what? Get off me! This is a fly, a pathogen, a fly. You're trying to kill it, but what do you know about this fly? In fact, you know nothing. You don't know if it's poisonous or not. You don't know how fast it can move. You don't know to which kind of biological species it belongs to. Well, do you really care? No. All you want is just to get rid of this as quick as you can. And this is your innate immune response. It is very rapid, but not very specific, and not very efficient. But while you're doing this, you're actually learning something about this fly. You're learning on which height it flies. You're learning how fast it can move. And you can sort of predict where it will go in a second. And then you focus, gather your strength, and you kill it, and this is your adaptive immune response. Specific, targeted, but delayed. Okay, this is the basics. So what I study in my PhD, I study a small pathogen called Leishmania. Well, don't bother memorizing that. It's a single cell parasite that gets inside our bodies, and it starts dividing, and usually it appears as a sort of a skin lesions. So normally our immune system is able to protect us. But sometimes this pathogen doesn't come alone. It comes with a friend, another pathogen, a virus. Actually, you see, many, many years ago, these two guys, they met, and they decided to be friends and live together. In fact, the virus lives inside the parasite, and they live in this symbiotic relationship. So when the parasite with the virus gets inside our body, inside our cells, our immune system recognizes this not as a fly, but as a sort of a T-Rex, and it's just panicking. It's just doing like this, unstoppable, trying to kill it, essentially, hitting itself. Yeah, it's getting completely out of control, destroying our own body, and it cannot stop. And so by the time we realize what's actually is going on, there is not only one fly in front of our face, but many, many more around us, because the parasite used this time to multiply and spread. Essentially, our adaptive immune response is able to protect us. But by this time, we slapped ourselves so many times, there's almost no face left, you know? And this is how amazing nature is, because two pathogens found each other to become a super pathogen and be stronger than if they would be separately. And you know, I ask you to resist to this infection, and right now with me, start practicing your adaptive immune response.
You speak about one pathogen that combined together. It exists a lot of this kind of pathogen, or is specific to your?
So what we study in our lab, we study basically, we use it as a model to study basic mechanisms of innate immune system. But in fact, there are many different cases in life when this sort of symbiotic relationship exists. And in some cases, these are the infectious diseases, the pathogens. And then basically it plays a significant role in the disease progression and also now in treatment.
Do you know if it is possible to have a bad pathogen, like a bad jury, like fungi, meet another bacterium or virus? together, they become friends, and the good virus tells the bad pathogen to be nice to you.
So you're saying you're not friends?
No, we are friends. But I thought I was your enemy, but now I'm your friend because I got a good influence.
Well, I don't know about this, but if you think from the evolutionary perspective, so the aim of the parasite is to find the host and then replicate and survive. And then since like all the nature evolves, so the host, the mammals, us, we also evolve, and our immune system is getting stronger and stronger to protect ourselves. So it's not only we who are adjust to the environment, but also the infections adjust. And that's why they found each other to be stronger and to resist the immune system. So I don't think what you're saying is like if two pathogens can become a good sort of beneficial for the host
the
organism.
The enemy of my enemy is my friend.
Well, they're not enemies, that's the thing, because the virus is not doing any harm to the parasite. they are friends from the beginning.
To interrupt this very interesting questions, but we have to move on. So thank you. Let's give another applause to Dmitry.